بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Continuing in volume 2 of Riyad al-Salihin, book number 17, the book of the prohibited actions, chapter 301, prohibition of putting oneself to undue hardship. Allah the Exalted says in Surah number 38, verse number 86, of which the meaning is, Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no wage do I ask of you for this, i.e. the Quran, nor am I one of the mutakallifun, those who pretend and fabricate things which do not exist. Narrated Umar radiallahu anhu, that we have been forbidden undue hardships. Al-Bukhari. Affection and artificiality are also different forms of formality which some people exercise in their speech, dress, and manners. To make unusual effort in hospitality and preparation of several dishes for meal also come in the category of formality which is greatly disliked. Unfortunately, present-day Muslims have made it a habit to spend lavishly on these extravagances. May Allah grant us guidance to adhere to the religious injunction in all matters of life. Ameen. Narrated Masruq radiallahu anhu, that we visited Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, and he said to us, O people, he who has the knowledge of any matter may convey it to the others, and he who has no knowledge thereof should say, Allahu A'lam, Allah knows better. It is a part and parcel of knowledge that a man who has no knowledge of a matter should say, Allah knows best. Allah said to his messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Say, O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no wage do I ask of you for this Quran, nor am I one of the mutakallifun, those who pretend and fabricate things which do not exist. Surah number 38, verse number 86, Al-Bukhari. If one does not know about something, he should not say anything about it by way of conjecture, speculation, and guesswork, because this is also pretension which is forbidden. When religious scholars are asked about anything which they do not know, they should confess their ignorance. Such a confession is also a mark of scholarship. In other words, they should abstain from giving verdict about any matter without making a thorough study and research of it. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.
It's really nice, beautiful comment about the first hadith, Hadith ibn Umar. May Allah be pleased with him, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam given them instruction that not to be among those who exaggerate in things or go beyond their means and their abilities. Doesn't matter if this in hospitality or in dress or life style. And actually, if we can put this hadith in our mind and think and reflect about it, I'm sure life will be much easier on us and our families. Because sometimes people looking for matching others try to be. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah faddala ba'dakum ala ba'din fil rizq. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had exalted some of us over than others in provision, in income, in different ways. So do not try to be walking in other people's shoes, you understand? Try to see what your shoes fits you and live with it. People sometimes even go beyond their means and ability, borrowing money or paying for things or buying on credit card or try, you understand, to match each other's weddings and parties and things like this is too much. Understand, people have different speeds. Everybody can work according to their speed. So if we can really reflect more about this hadith, it's called takalluf from kalafa, that you're going to be costly for something that is not in your means, is not. And this same thing also apply in the knowledge. You don't have, say, Allahu A'lam, Allah knows best, and this it. Say, oh brother, bought this, and you start to get this from east and west, and put combination together to make up an answer. You don't have to do this. Allah doesn't want us to go beyond our means, our abilities, our speed, okay? You know you can, this amount or this same, you don't say, I don't know. And the beauty of it is, say what? The saying of Allahu A'lam, for what you don't know, is part of knowledge. This is shows that you are knowledgeable because you acknowledge the ability of yourself. You did not try to put yourself in a position that you are not in. Same thing with medicine, with curing, with helping others. We try to direct me. You from Colombia, do you know what is the Greyhound bus station? Here goes this way. If you don't know, yeah, I'm from Colombia, but I don't know where is the bus station, okay? But do not try to go that you don't push people. You're okay? Stay where Allah put you. This is it. Inshallah. Hopefully this will be something beneficial for all of us, inshallah. Jazakallah khairan. May Allah bless your day. It is recommended for the dua that the person raise his hands, that he send peace and the blessing on the Prophet before the dua, that he call on Allah with his beautiful names, okay? And it would be nice that whatever needs that you want, you understand that you ask Allah with the name that matches this. So if you're asking for provision, you ask with the name, Ya Razzaq, Ya Wahab, Ya Mu'ati, okay? If you're asking about something for Allah to keep away from you, okay? Ya Mani, Ya Muqtadir, you understand? All these things is he made the dua more mustajab. Also about try to meet the proper time, like between the adhan and the iqama. This is one time. In the last part of the night, okay? So the condition, as well as the time, as well as the saying. And when you raise your hands, you understand, also shows the needs, because you're begging Allah, you see? And also that you call in Allah with yaqeen and certainty that Allah will answer the call, because you believe that he is Sami', that he is all-hearing, and to appeal to Allah with all these combinations of things, this more for surety for the dua. And if the thing doesn't come, that the person continue. Okay? This is called ilhad, to insist and to keep asking again and again and again.
Persistent.
Inshallah, and Allah knows best.
And I have a dua before, we said before we enter the bathroom and when we dress.
No. This ad'iyya does not have raised hands, nothing.
Oh, not that?
No.
What is it called? Ad'iyya?
Ad'iyya means the plural of dua.
Oh, it's not dua. It's a dua, right?
It's a dua and it is a dhikr, understand, but it's not been known to the Prophet to raise his hand in things like this.
Or
needs and begging Allah for things, you understand? Like as example, you don't say Bismika Allahumma amutu wa ahya when you go to sleep, okay? No, you say it, and they say it because we don't have any statement or description from the Sahaba that the Prophet raised his dua hands in this, okay? And Allah knows best. Ask Allah for fulus. Yes, ask Allah whatever that you want. Don't be shy, understand, to ask Allah exactly your needs and your wants. And you have a nice suit, brother. Like the stars. The stars all the way up.
We have a better position in